I know, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Relating to the AVL system that was presented in court as evidence by Mr. Dupriez, I'll not go through all the stops or all the places where we're driven, where that vehicle was driven by Sergeant Mkhane, but there are certain spots or places where they are relevant insofar as the version of accused number two. All right. Firstly, it has been placed on record during cross-examination that on the 18th, a motor vehicle stopped at an engine garage in Alberton. And according to the version of accused number two, his instruction was that after they went to Carltonville or to the place where he's working, Mr. Mkhane and Sergeant Mabena were driving a Toyota Fortuna and he saw a boat reflecting Albertine next to that engine garage. That's where they stopped. So I'm putting to you that that version of accused number two has been confirmed by the AVL of the 18th. Can you dispute it?
No, I can't dispute it. I can't dispute that, my lord, because I was not there. I was not driving with the accused. Okay.
Umangalelo wesibini yena uthe ngalesikhathi bekade kushayelwa imoto eya laphaya emsebenzini yena ithe makulibele kuhanjwa uye wabona ibhod ebhalwe Albertine kulayo ukuthi imoto iye yamanga khona. Manje ungakwazi ukuphika lokho na ukuthi cha ngoba bengingekho ngeke ngikwazi ukuphika lokho?
This the after the so that's why he alleged that he was assaulted next to that engine garage. And most of the witnesses obviously denied that. And at that garage.
All the witnesses denied that?
All the witnesses.
Because when you say most of them, it means some others didn't deny
that. All the witnesses denied that. Thereafter, he he said, when they stopped at that garage, they were joined by Jonathan Mapumulo and Buthelezi, where the assault took place. After that, they traveled. On that night, they went to, because he was taken to another motor vehicle that was driven by Jonathan. Went to a place next to or near a dumping area. That's when you feature in, where you arrived with Sergeant Mkhola and another male person who was wearing braces.
Excuse me, Lord, what time was this, if I can just
on the 18th, in the evening of the 18th or
No, but that's not true, my lord. As I said, I met the accused in Carltonville, followed the alibi, found to be false. We parted ways. I've never seen him again until I met him on the 19th at Booking Police Station. So I never had any.
Sorry to interject. Mr. Ngomezulu's question relates to the 18th. When yes. First, in other words, if you want to respond,
yes.
When first did you meet that person? Because it has been proved to you that actually, you did meet him on the 18th in the evening. That's the assertion.
Yes, my lord. That's what I'm saying, my lord. That I did meet him on the 18th at Carltonville mine. This okay. is where we're following the alibi that says he okay. was at work and found to be false. Subsequent to that meeting and the admissions or rather utterances that he's willing to make a confession, I left with Sergeant Mkhola. that is now from Carltonville. I never saw him again. I never traveled together with him and Sergeant Mohane. We went our separate ways. I went to the provincial office, sorry, my national office, took my car and went home, and only met him the following day in the evening. This is after his court appearances as Phuket. So on the 18th, my lord, I only met him in Carltonville to follow up on the first false alibi. Thereafter, we parted ways. I was never in Alberton, my lord, with him.
Umeli kamangalelo wesibini uthi umangalelo wesibini uthi yena ithemaka ngale ngase Alberton eno Sergeant Mokola yena nomabhena kulayi ukuthi kuye kwafika uJonathan Buthelezi nomunye futhi kulayi ukuthi bona mabafika kuye kwaqhutshekwa ukuthi ashawe wasuswa wafakwa kwenye imoto le ebekade kuhamba aboJonathan ngayo wayisiwa kwenye indawo ethize nalapho kulayi ukuthi ubrigadier uye wafika ehamba noSergeant Mokola. Sergeant ubrigadier uyala uthi cha mina umangalelo wesibini niqale ukumbona eCarltonville njengoba besiya siyofuna le siyophenya le ndaba yasemsebenzini njengoba bekathi bekasemsebenzini. Ukusuka lapho angizange ngimbone ngoba ngithema ngisuka eCarltonville ngengaya emsebenzini ngathatha imoto yami ngahamba ngaya ekhaya ngazohlangana naye kusasa uma sisephukeni. Angizange mina ngibe naye umangalelo ebusuku kule ndawo le ayichaza.
And furthermore, my lord, that's why I said, and I've testified about this area, that it, for me, based on the OBs that were collected of his detention on that very same day, my lord, there was no indication that he was assaulted, because I had the privilege of organizing the OBs. Subsequent to the mechanical fault that was reported by Sergeant Mohane, that was reported to me by Sergeant Mohane, I do know that subsequently was detained, was booked, he was taken through the OB registers in the morning hours of the 19th, booked out for court proceedings on the 19th. Nowhere does it reflect at any stage that he was assaulted when he was there.
Futhi.
Okay.
Futhi ye, umangalelwa mina, uma ngibuka, konke la kubhalwe khona. Akukho la ukuthi kuye kwabhalwa ukuthi umangalelwa ungene eshayiwe noma ekhishwa eshayiwe esitokisini. Ngoba uma ngisuka mina, uma ngiyobuka nazo lezo incwadi ezibhaliwe, azikho la zibonakalisayo ukuthi nangummangalelwa makangena e-police station ethize uneyimpawu zokuthi ushayiwe noma uthe ushayiwe. Akukho la kuchaza khona.
Sorry, Mr. Mgomezelo, for clarity, the court's clarification. You're putting it to Brigadier Gnenda that at the dumping area he was there.
That's correct.
And he came with Mohane.
Yes.
The lady.
Yes.
Sergeant Mohane.
That's correct.
And you say your client was assaulted there.
That's correct.
Now, Mohane too being a woman, assaulted, because you say he was assaulted there. You didn't differentiate whether Mohane being a woman didn't assault or what. Mm. So I take it when you say he was assaulted by all the police there, you include Mohane.
My lord, on record I've put that he was assaulted by Jonathan Mabena Buthelezi.
Yes.
And on the arrival of Brigadier Gininda with Sergeant Mohane and the man with the braces.
Yes.
And Sergeant Mohane now was not participating in
Mohane, you say he just looked.
Yes.
But he never dealt with Mohane.
Never.
That's what I want to know.
Yes. The only version I got in relation to Mohane assaulting was from accused number one, that she participated in the assault of accused number one. That's the instruction I got from accused number one.
And then the man with braces?
No.
He did nothing.
He did not.
He just played with his braces.
I beg your pardon?
He just played with his braces.
No, I can't say that.
Because you say he was there also.
Maybe he was in company.
No. I
don't even know him.
To get your client's version so that I mustn't be confused.
Yes.
Because the police and the SWAT team.
Yes.
You are saying they assaulted your client.
That's correct. Right. As they were mentioned,
yes,
Jonathan.
Yes. Okay, fine.
Mabena and Buthelezi.
Okay, fine. Okay, thank you.
Manje mawuthi ummangalelo wesibini ushayiwe kule yandawo la kulahlwa khona izibi. Ubrigadier umake fika nalensizwa le enye no Sergeant Mokhola. Nabo bafike bamshaya na no Sergeant Mokhola lo wesifazane. Washaya na ummangalelo wesibini uthi cha ngithe uJonathan uMabhena uMaphumulo yibona ekuthi baye bashaya ummangalelo wesibini. Eyokushaywa kwakamangal eyokushaya umhola la ashaye umuntu khona kulama kashaya ummangalelo wokuqala. Akusukuthi ngommangalelo wesibini uye wamshaya nakhona.
Okay.
My lord, no, I denied it. It's not true. As I said, I was not there. If I was in the vicinity or company of accused number two, I would have recorded, as I did when we followed the alibi. There's no reason for me not to mention that I'm with him. And secondly, there is no way I would have allowed, as an officer, because then I was a full colonel, I would have allowed junior members to embark on such atrocious acts. There is no way, there is no purpose, there was no benefit in that. I warned the accused according to his rights. He voluntarily freely told me that he's prepared to make a confession. What would be the purpose of the assault, my lord? But I wasn't there. The only thing that I was told about was that there was a car, there was a mechanical issues with the vehicle, and subsequently then they made it back to the police station. So I deny that I was there and witnessed any assault.
Manje ke ubrigadier uthi le ndaba yokushawa kukamangalelo wesibini wayekade engekho futhi njengoba kuthiwa uye wafika kuleyo ndawo umangalelwa elibele eshawa uthi yena bengeke avume ukuthi umsolwa ashawe ngenxa yokuthi ngaleso sikhathi bekuwukenel bekanamandla wokuthi avimbe noma akhuze abantu abashaya umuntu oyekuthi yena ngokwakhe uyasho ukuthi ufuna ukugonyuluka ufuna ukuchaza ukuthi kwenzakele futhi yena njengomphathi wabo bengeke abavumele ukuthi bashaye ummangalelwa noma umsolwa yena ekhona bekungena sizathu bekungena nto ebazoyizuza uma beshaya umuntu isikhulukazi yena ngokwakhe uma eyena athi uyafisa ukuthi akhulume axoxe ukuthi kwenzakele.
If we proceed to the following day, the 19th, okay, on that, in the early hours of the 19th, at 2:30, that's when he was booked at Pretoria North. And few minutes and few hours, he was booked out again. And that's when he was told that he was going to appear in Fort Lauderdale. Suddenly, according to him, he saw himself in Soweto. He's not familiar with Soweto, but what is important about what his version is that he did not sign any document. Maybe could be purported to be a confession. In the morning of the 19th of June 2020.
My lord, what I know, there was an understanding between myself and accused two on the 19th that he is freely and voluntarily willing to make a confession to an independent officer. Subsequent to that, arrangements were made for such a confession to be taken, and indeed it was taken. The document I received from Lieutenant Colonel Rappard, I think a day or so or after, in his office in Ennerdale, was signed on the portion where accused two, or rather a deponent or a suspect is supposed to be signing. It was signed, my lord. And I didn't get any indication, as I've said, even when I met him later on that day, on the 19th, because the confession was concluded just before midday. When I met him later in Phukeng at the police station, there was no indication, my lord, that he's got complaints. But subsequent to that, my lord, even in Phukeng, he was detained there when the ammunition was found, and then booked out again to Primrose Police Station. Nowhere does it reflect even there, my lord, that it's at any stage he complained of assault or any assault were detected, my lord.
Manje ke ungo ntathabusa imizuzu emashumi amathathu ngemva kwehora lesibini ummangalelwa wesibini yena uye wathathwa wafakwa esitokisini bamkhipha ngemva kwesikhashanyana amahora ambalwa yena wazibeka isuka eFort Lauderdale kodwa ugcine sekazibona eSoweto le ukuthi akayazi iSoweto umbangala lo esibini nge 19 zika June 2020 bese kulayi ukuthi ugcine seke sekazohlangana noma sekabonana no brigadier uyaphika u brigadier uthi cha lokho mina angikwazi engikwaziyo nje ukuthi umangalelwa yena ngokwakhe uye wathi uyafisa ukuthi akhulume ukuthi kwenza keleni ingakho egcine sekuthi uyisiwa khona eSoweto ukuze ayokhuluma khona lapho mina ke ngubrigadier ngathola lawo maphepha abekade umangalelwa asayinile kuwo nabo usayina khona umuntu uma eqeda ukukhuluma isitatimende esifana naleso bese ke mina ngiyengahlangana naye sengihlangana naye futhi ephukeni wagcinwa khona lapho esitokisini ephukeni wasuswa ephukeni wayisiwa ePrimrose kulayi ukuthi mina nommangalelwa besilibele sihlangana khona nala sihlangene khona ephukeni akazange ummangalelwa angitshele noma angazise ukuthi unesikhalazo esithize ngento eyenzakele kuye yena ummangalelwa zange angitshele lokho.
Brigadier, I appreciate the fact that there's so much that you want to explain, but I'll ask you to at least give me an answer according to the question that I'm asking, and because the reason is because I'm following the instruction as it is, because I'm not in Phukeng as yet, I'm still at Moroka Police Station. Then my instruction and the questions that I need to put across to you, they must make such a relevant sequence. Because what I want to, when I'm asking you, the version that I'm putting across to you, it must be confirmed by the AVL system. That's why I'm taking two things in one time, so that you can have a smooth.
My Lord, I understand it, but my explanation, in other words, I do give an answer, and then I give an explanation in relation to the specific day council is referring to. So it's not that I'm giving answers that are haphazard. So I will say, for example, on the 18th, this is not correct. When I refer to the OBs, I'm referring to the OBs of the 18th. Now on the 19th, I've referred to the 19th, and I've referred to the occurrence book of the 19th in Phukeng and subsequently when he was moved to Primrose, because it's relevant to the question that I'm being asked, my Lord.
Uthumeli ucela ukuthi ubrigadier aphendule lokho ambuza bona uyazwisisa futhi uyajabula nokuthi kunezinye azigcwaliselayo kodwa ucela ukuthi aphendule lokho ambuza bona ngenxa yokuthi usahamba ngendlela ethize ekuthi ucebiswe umbangalelo ukuthi abuze kanjena nakanjena azilandelelane manje ubrigadier uthi uma ngiphendula bese ngiyagcwalisela ngicwalisela kuzo lezo zinto zangalondondanga ongibuza ngalo akusuke ukuthi ngikhuluma ngezinto zelanga elithize ngombuzo othize ngiphendula ngigcwalise kulezi zinto ekuthi usakhuluma ngazo ezihambelanayo nawo lo mbuzo owubuzayo.
For instance, accused number 2 confirmed that he was transported from Pretoria to Morocco, although he didn't know that he was at Morocco, and that was also confirmed by the AVL. After Morocco, he was transported to Vosloorus Court, and that is also confirmed by the AVL. This is what I'm putting across to you so that we flow with the.
No, I agree, my Lord. And the AVL records, I seem to recall that they reflect such, that he went to Morocco and went to, subsequent to that, then he went to Vosloorus Magistrate Court, my Lord. We agree.
Mangalelwa esibini yena uthe ususwe esiphoyiseni sasePretoria wayisiwa eMoroka nangokho wayekade engazi ukuthi kuseSoweto kuseMoroka kodwa uyisiwe khona kusuka lapho wayisiwa eVosloorus enkantolo uthi yebo ubrigadier uyavuma njengoba ne-AVL ichaza isho kanjalo.
And it is further my instruction that at Vosloorus he did not confirm, he did not appear in court. That has been confirmed by Sergeant Mkhan to say he did not appear in court, but because the matter was not placed on the roll. Soon thereafter, they traveled. When they traveled, he saw a boat bearing Albertine. This is the second time he saw the board reflecting the name Albertine. That is also confirmed in terms of what he explained by the AVN. Because according to the AVN, they drove from First Lawrence Court, joint entry, and off-ramp at Hagelberg Road. They joined Hagelberg Road.
My Lord, as I said, I was not there. I was not traveling with him, so I'm not sure how can I assist counsel on that.
Manjege, itemak suwa ge enkantolo yase First Lawrence kulayi kuthi uthi umangalelwa uye manje sekuyihlanga lesibini ebona ibhodi ebekade ibhalwe Albertine naye kuthi iyavune AVL nayo ivumelana nayo uthi ubrigadier bengingekho ngeke ngikwazi ukuvuma noma ukuphika lokho.
So when they joined Hagelberg Road there were stops at that road. There was a stop at Hagelberg Road. And they were driving towards, after that stop, they were driving towards Newmarket in Albertine. And that has been confirmed by the AVN. And where they stopped, he said it was near a dumping area where he was assaulted.
My Lord, like I said, I was not there really. I really don't know. I'm not shying away with the answer, but I was not traveling with them.
Semani Kwezuga, Yagumkwako, Hagelberg, Nina Nienaya, Gwindao, Ebizwa, Inu Market, Gunendao, Nalapo, Eguti, Nienaya Kona, Indaweni. Did you say a dumping or?
Next to a dumping area.
Next to a dumping area. Niena yanga setuze. Wenda wana gulatwa kona izibi. Gula iguti na kona uye wa shawa. Utu brigadiri. Ngozi nkantolo bengingeko. Angege mwazo ugusho uguti ipendu leganja. Ngoba ganga tengeko la.
What I do know, my Lord, is that on the 19th, as I indicated, when I met him at Phukeng Police Station, the very same day, because subsequent to all these activities of going to Morocco, because that's what I recall, that I was told something was forgotten in Morocco Police Station. Then we met in Phukeng Police SAPS. I did not see any visible injuries on accused two. I did not get an indication that he was assaulted. Even the occurrence book at that station when he was detained does not reflect such, my Lord.
Ngalo lelo langa lange 18 njengoba bekade 19 ngeilanga le 19 njengoba umangalelo wayekade ebuya eMorocco kuyiwa eFort Lawrence mina uma ngiyohlangana naye ePhukeng akukho la kubhalwe khona ukuthi umangalelwa ushayiwe futhi akukho nala ngimbone khona nami uma ngifika ngihlangana naye la ngimbone ukuthi ubekade eshayiwe noma eneyimpawu zokushaywa noma yena angitshela ukuthi ushayiwe ngalo lelo suku. Angizange ngibuze lokho.
At the stop that she talks about is also shown in the AVL and bears the street name Ring Road. After that, he was taken to, that's when they went to Soweto. That's according to his version. From Albertine, they drove to Soweto with Sergeant Mabena and Constable Mabena and Sergeant Mukhani. He saw the motor vehicle entering Chris Hani Baragwanath Hospital, where for the first time he saw Colonel Rapat, but he didn't know that it was Colonel Rapat. They entered the premises. That's when they took that man who left his keys to his wife and joined them. Where they stopped, according to his version, they stopped at a place next to
where there are discarded ATM machines.
Yes. That's where he was assaulted. He was assaulted up to the time when you arrived on that night with Sergeant Mkhola and that male person with the braces. That's when you were driving a white BMW. You sat on the edge of the back of the motor vehicle of that BMW, and you took out some document wherein you told him that he must sign here, otherwise they'll proceed with what they were doing.
Yeah. So, my lord, but that's not true, my lord. After the court proceedings, after accused one, accused two was not enrolled, what I recall, and I recall this on what I, what is documented in the AVL, I might not be precise with everything. From, I'm not sure about the stops of Alberton, but subsequent to the Sergeant Mohane leaving East Rand, he went to Moroka. From Moroka, the AVL shows my lord in that afternoon that he drove towards Pretoria, taking, I think it's the N4, to the Northwest Province. Nowhere did that vehicle drive back to Baragwanath Hospital and stop. The AVL record shows that. Nowhere does that vehicle from Moroka goes to a place with the ATM dumping site. That is not correct. And at no stage when the vehicle went to Northwest did it go back to that area, because I never, when I left my office, I went to meet them at Phukeng SAPS. And the AVL shows such, my lord. From Moroka, it goes towards Pretoria. I think, if I recall, it's N4 towards Northwest up to the time it got to the SAPS in Phukeng. And that's where I met them. So that part of the vehicle or them going to Moroka, it's not correct because it's not supported by AVL. But secondly, I never went to meet them at an area that dumps ATM, and I did indicate, my lord, that I've never really, because ATMs are regulated, I've never seen a site, even up to today, where they dump ATMs. I don't think you can actually do that. I've not seen it, my lord, in my whole experience as a detective or as a police officer. I've never come across such, my lord.
Ubrigadire uyala loludaba lwakho lokuthi nisukile laphaya nazo dlula nibuyela eSoweto nangena esibhedlele eBaragwana lanyena hlangana noKennel Rapadu ethatha izinto azisa kunkosikazi wakhe bese nibuyela eMroka bese nibuya ePretoria niye eFukeni. Uthi cha, lokho akakwazi. Futhi uthi kusukela ngalesikhathi eqala ukusebenza kufikela namanje akaze yena wabona indawo la ukuthi kulahlwa khona ama-ATM. Uthi ngoba ama-ATM anemithetho ethize, nale nto yokuthi ufike wahlala phezu kwemoto i-BMW wakhipha amaphepha wathi wena usayine noma labantu ababazoqhubeka ngento bebalibeli bayenza kuwe, uthi nayo cha akusiyiqiniso, akayazi leyo nto leyo, ayizange iyenzakale yena ekhona. Into ayikhumbulayo ukuthi kusuke Soweto moto yahamba yabuyela ePretoria yathatha umgwaqo u-N4 yaya-ke eNorthwest, kulayi ukuthi naye ke wahlangana nawe khona laphaya ePhukeni.
And lastly, my lord, on that aspect, I did indicate that when I spoke to Colonel Rapado, requested him to assist me with the taking of the confession of accused two. It was a person that I've never met in my whole life, so I did not even know how he looks like. It was just one was going through the standby list at the provincial office of officers that were available that one can ask. Subsequent to that, I only met him day or 2 days later in Ennerdale police station for the first time, and that is where the exchanging of documents took place. In other words, where he gave me the confession in hand. That was not on the 19th, my lord.
40 yena ubekaqala ukuhlangana no Colonel Rapadu ngalesikhathi ethatha istatement ebeseni sigcwalisile wena no Colonel Rapadu, ekuchaza ukuthi wena wabona uRapadu ngaphambi kokuthi yena ambona, akaze abone uRapadu ngaphambi kokuthi athole lesa statement. Yena uye wabheka nje incwadi ukuthi abobani abantu abakhona abangasiza kwi-province uwenza indictment ezinjalo ingakho ke ugcine sekuthi uthola uRaphadu and the accused is raising his hand, my lord.
May I approach the
office? Yes.
So, Brigadier Kininda, I just want to correct you. I didn't say it's a place where they are dumping the ATMs. Maybe you heard me wrong. I said it's a place next to the ATMs that are no longer functioning, according to the version of accused number two. That's where he was forced to sign documents that you took out from the vehicle and gave them to Colonel Raphadu. Then he was forced to sign those documents. He never, he did not make any statement. The statement was already made, but forced to sign it. After signing the statement, there was a thumbprint, a stamp for the thumbs to be printed on the papers. So that stamp, so other pages were not stamped. And according to him, that's what he heard, that certain pages were not stamped, which were eventually stamped at Morocco, at that police station where he was taken to.
My lord, I still go back to the fact that on the 19th, after the court proceedings, the vehicle went to Morocco, because it boils down to that, from Morocco, Pretoria, and Northwest. Nowhere did it go. It's the AVL. The records are available and we gave the defense. It doesn't, after the court proceedings, which ended around 1400 hours, I think around there, there is nowhere, if one looks at those AVL records, where that vehicle from Morocco police station goes back to Paraguanat and goes in there and then goes to a place where machines are not functioning. Because even if we take it on that context, my lord, that the machines, ATM machines that are functioning, I've never seen that. When those things are removed by specialists, they dispose of them, I think secretly, because obviously there's financial issues involved. I've never seen a site in Soweto. I grew up in Soweto. I've never seen a site in Soweto where ATMs are just stored there because they're not functioning. So that version is not true, my lord.
Agaza wayibona indawo la kubekwa khona noma la kulahlwa ama ATM angasasebenzi. Uthi uyacabanga ukuthi ama ATM masisiwa angasasebenzi kunendawo la ukuthi ayisiwa khona mhlawumbe ayo hlakazwa khona noma kwenziweni ngawo ngenxa yokuthi asebenza ngemali. Ayikho indawo la kulahlwa noma kubekwa ama ATM esowe. Into ayaziyo ukuthi imoto ngalelalanga isuke eMorocco yaya ePretoria yaya eNorthwest. Kulayi ukuthi imoto ihambe khona uthi naye uyazi lokho ukuthi imoto ihambe lapho. Ayikho indaba leyo ukuthi imoto yeyaya kuleya ndawo la uthi kubekwa ama ATM angasasebenzi. Uyakuphika lokho.
And it's my instruction that when he was transported to Phuket, you did not meet them in Phuket. You were traveling with them with your own motor vehicle. You were following each other. You were traveling together with, actually you were following each other until to the place where you reside. You resided.
No, that's not true, my lord. I met them at Phukeng police station, and the AVL shows that that vehicle, the one with the AVL, stopped at Phukeng police station. It was my instruction to Sergeant Mohane that they must drive there and I will meet them. When I arrive, we identified ourselves, followed the procedures of indicating that we are there on investigation, requested the local vehicle to take us, the sector vehicle, to the address that accused two was taking us to. So that's not correct. I was not traveling with them, my lord. If I was following them, why would I keep that away? It's insignificant. I was not there. I met them at Phukeng police station, my lord.
Ubrigadier uyaphika futhi njengoba usho utshela ummeli wakho Ntanzi ukuthi nihlange benilandelelana bebanilandelela yena ngemoto yakhe emuva kwale ebenina nihamba ngayo uthi cha akukho njalo yena watshela uSergeant Mohane ukuthi ayifikele epolice station yasePhukeng uzohlangana nabo lapho bafike bahlangana lapho bazazisa kumaphoyisa wasePhukeng maqedwa kwakhishwa imoto yasePhukeng ibekade ihamba nabo ini iya kule ndawo la bekade uhlala khona.
Some of the things are common cause such as when you travel to Phukeng, you entered his premises, ammunition was found, he was taken to Phukeng police station. Those things are things that he never disputed. But things that are relating to his assault, relating to the docket 636.
You understand the reason? Sometimes if it is something, I did not say I admit.
The point that I'm driving to is the one who was taken to Primrose. You also came in Primrose, you met him there. I think the 20th up to the date, on the 20th he met you there. That's when, on that day, you apologized to him. You apologized to Mr. Ntanzi for having been assaulted, and that's when you made a promise to him that you can offer. May I just confirm that the...
Hello?
May I just confirm with the accused how much was it offered?
Ah, I see.
So the point of correction is that you arrived at Pretoria police station. It was on Sunday, a day before he was taken to to the dentist, because he was taken to the dentist on the 22nd of June. But you came to see him on the 21st, I believe, because it was a Sunday. That's when you apologized to him. You requested him to work with you, to cooperate, and that's why you offered him 3 million. You offered him 3 million as long as he's going to make sure that he's implicating the right people.
Mm. Yeah, I've heard it, my lord. This is the first. I mean, I've heard versions. I'm shocked. Anyway, my lord, that is...
About the bribe.
Actually, the police are bribing accused or suspects. I've never heard. It's the first time where the state, or rather the police officers, are offering accused persons or suspects 3 million. I've never heard it. It's the first time. Mm. But I must say, my lord, it's absolutely not true. It's a lie. I'll put it in that strong context. It's absolute lies. There's no budget, my lord, that I have even to make such an offer. I didn't have a budget of 3 million for the unit during that time. I didn't have that budget. Let's just start there. I don't have it, my lord. Now, and I don't know even if it was available, my lord, why would I do that? The accused cooperated with me on the 18th. He told me that he's willing to make a statement freely and voluntarily. Subsequent to that, on the 19th in the morning, he made a confession. The confession was made in the morning of the 19th. What is the point of going to him on the 21st and offer him whatever promises? There was no promises made.
So you're saying, by the way, the confession was made on the 19th?
It was made on the 19th. So,
yes. Okay.
So on the 21st, which is being put now to me, my lord, the confession was made. I met the accused and discussed the issues of the confession with him on the 18th. 19th, it gets made. We meet again on the 19th in the evening in Phukeng. Then he gets taken to Primrose Police Station. From then, my lord, I never met him. That is now from the 28th in the morning hours until I met him on the 22nd. I didn't meet him on the 21st. I was not the IO. Sergeant Mohane was the one dealing with him. And there was no such offers. First, like I said, my lord, my unit that time in 2020 did not have that budget that I could give you account as a state. But that's why I said I'm shocked, my lord. I'm out of words. Why would you offer an accused person, a suspect, money to do what, my lord? He gave a version in the form of a confession. I followed it to corroborate it, and subsequent to that, presented the evidence to the DPP. There was nothing malicious. It was based on the evidence that we had found, my lord, that led to this matter starting.
Ukuya ngo brigadier nabo ukwenza ke. Nishangene nge 18 wena wamtshela ntanzi ukuthi uzimisele ukukhuluma ukuthi kwenza ke le. Bese nge 19 bulayi ukuthi uye wayo khuluma ukuthi kwenza ke leni. Bese ke ngazo i 19 kula uye waya ephukeni. Ubekade ehlangene nawe ephukeni leya nge 21 eyokuthi ufike yena waxolisa kuwe, wathi usebenzisane naye, wathi uzokunika imali elingana no 3 million. Yena uthi akanayo, wayekade engenayo ngaleso sikhathi, ne unit asebenza kuyo yayikade ingenayo leyo mali. Nangokho mhlawumbe asithi yayikhona leyo mali, thasikho isizathu esingayenza ukuthi yena kuyiphoyisa eliphethe angakhipha imali athi ithinginike nangu umuntu uthi ufuna ukuze lo muntu lona aze asitele iqiniso. Uthi asikho isizathu esingayenza ukuthi akhiphe imali anike umsolwa, lo msolwa loyo yena ngokwakhe wayekade ethe ufuna ukukhuluma. Akasiboni isizathu futhi nge-21 akazange nhlobo ahlangane nawe. Uthi lawo amanga alihlaza, kudala ezwa abantu bekhuluma izinto ezihlukile, kodwa le eyanamuhla uthi uyayiqala impica badala akaze wezwa ukukhulunywa indaba efana.
Lastly, my lord, on the confession that he made on the 19th, the accused that are before court were already implicated. There's nothing that he left out. On the morning confession, although I got it a day or 2 days later, but he implicated everyone, my lord. So this assertion that I would have made a proposal with him, to him implicated the role each and every person played, if one looks into that confession, my lord. It's self-explanatory. You don't have to ask anything. You simply have to follow and collaborate what is contained there, my lord.
Food. Kulesiya statement lesi phecelezi I confession wena Ntanzi usho yonke into ukhulume yonke into ukuthi ubani kunabamangalelwa ohleli nabo ukuthi lo wenzeni lo wayenzani lo ingxenye yakhe lo indima yakhe wenze bekungena sizathu ebesingayenza ubrigadier ukuthi agcine sekuthi ukhipha imali engako noma umkomelo ongako ukuthi ukhulume ngoba yena bekwamele nje alandele zonke lezi zinto ekuthi usuzishiye.
And it's an unlawful act, my lord, that I will not embark on. The matter that I was seized with when it was, sorry, counsel, to interject. This matter, when it was given to me, my lord, it was given to me as a case to investigate. No special treatment or interest I have, as the deceased in this matter is not known to me. The accused before court are not known to me. The witnesses, or all the people who were in the house are not known to me. None of the people involved in this matter, my lord, have personal relations with me or unknown to me. It was just a matter that was assigned to me, which could have been assigned to anyone. And I investigated that matter on those basis, my lord, nothing more.
Futhi bekuyinto engekho emthethweni ukuthi angayenza ubrigadier athi nawo umkomelo ngoba unikwe leli cala. Yena ayikho into ekuthi bekwamele ayenze ngaphandle kokuthi aphenye ngoba abantu laba umufi wayekade engamazi futhi nalabantu abekade belaphaya kulesi sigameko wayekade engabazi nani bamangalelwa uthi wayekade enganazi leli cala icala ekuthi walinikwa yena ukuthi aliphenye icala ebelinganikwa unoma ubani yena wayekade engeke ayenze leyo nto yokuthi anike umuntu imali.
Now, the question is, which day did you meet Mr. Mchiako in the presence of accused number two?
The 23rd, my lord. I think I indicated this. The 23rd of June, the day before the confession was made of the 24th.
Hlangene nini nomnumzana uMchiako, ummeli lo bekade enomangalelwa wesibini, uthi sahlangana nge 23.
All right. So the 24th is the day, the following day, he made the alleged second confession before the magistrate.
Yes, that's the day he made the confession to the magistrate, my lord.
Basically, 24 ilanga la umangalelo esibini uye wayo yenza le confession futhi ku esibini kumanje.
There's something that you said, I think it's yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, when you said you did not know how accused number two communicated with Mr. Mchiako, but you met Mr. Mchiako at a police station.
Yeah, my lord, what I recall, the question was put to me, if I saw some letter or appointment letter, but instructions basically that were given to Mr. Mchiako, and my answer was no. The first time I met him was after I received a call that there is a legal representative who wants to consult with accused two. I've explained that, my lord. Then I went there. That was the first time I came face to face with Mr. Mchiako for the first time in my whole life. And then obviously then he identified himself after accused two said, this is my attorney. And then I've indicated what happened, my lord, without repeating saying.
Bewuchaze ukuthi uhlangene kanjani noMchiako uthi mina ngiye ngacebiswa ukuthi kunomuntu othi ungummeli ufuna ukukhulumisana nomangalelwa mina kulaye ukuthi ngaya bengiqala ukuhlangana naye empilweni yami uma uMchiako wafika wazichaza ukuthi ungubani waphinda futhi wazisho nokuthi yena usebenza ukwenzani into ezinjalo engeke ngiphinde nanamuhla.
Yeah, the question was about instruction letter, my lord. Yes, so I responded to say no, I didn't see it and I don't know how, you know, he he would have given the instructions. But it's his constitutional rights, my lord, to be legally represented. There was nothing peculiar about it to have been attended.
Umbuzo bengibuze ngokuthi waze umangalelwa uxhumene kanjani nommeli, mina bengingazi nokuthi uxhumene kanjani, kodwa ilungelo lakhe njengomuntu oyikuthi ubekade evalelwe ukuthi axhumane nommeli angazi ukuthi baxhumene kanjani.
The accused number two will deny having instructed Mr. Mchiago, and he deny having signed a confession before a magistrate. The only thing that he can recall after Boxberg on the day of the alleged confession, he was taken to another place next to industrial area in Jimston, where he was assaulted, and that's when he bled some blood stains spilled on those documents. And so far as his recollection is concerned, the document that he signed must have blood stains, not the one that was produced by the magistrate in court.
Sorry, for my understanding, the way you're putting the assertion, you say your client will deny that he has instructed Mr. Mjiak, right?
That's correct.
And then you say also your client will deny that he signed a confession before a magistrate, meaning the white lady, Ms. Gronje, right?
Correct.
And then you put the tail. What he will say is he was taken to a place in Jemiston, is that it?
That's correct.
And assaulted.
That's correct.
Now I want to know, when was the assault? For my understanding, because the concatenation of events as you are narrating them, when you say he'll deny, he's assaulted on which day?
On the 24th.
On the 24th?
Yes.
At about what time?
In the evening.
In the evening. And this is before or after?
It's after
he was forced to sign that?
A confession.
Alleged confession.
Alleged confession.
Is it before or after? According to instructions.
When he was assaulted, that's when he was forced to sign a confession.
Okay, so
on that night,
okay,
of the 24th.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine. All right.
So, my lord, what I know, maybe just for clarity, what is the question, counsel, so that I answer what you've asked me?
I'm putting a version to say accused number two will deny having instructed Mr. Mchiako, will deny that he signed a confession before a magistrate. The only document he signed was a document shown to him in Jimston around industrial area. That's where he was compelled, because he was beaten there, to sign the document.
Okay, no, I understand now. So, my lord, no. Let me start with Mr. Mjapo. I don't know how the instructions were given, but what I know, on the 23rd, he, accused two, stood up and said, this is my attorney, before the introductions by Mr. Mjapo. That is the first part. The second part, on the 24th, when at a later stage I received the confession document, by the way, that did not have blood stains, because I have the original confession document, and it's available, my lord. There are no blood stains.
They say it must have blood stains.
No, it doesn't have, my lord. I can show it to the court, and we dealt with it. That
no, you can't show it to me. Do you want to see it, Mr.
No.
Gomezul?
No, my lord.
It's okay, fine.
It's available, my lord. It does not have a single stain of blood, that I can put it that far. Now, and in that document, Mr. Mchiako is recorded by the magistrate as the legal representative of accused number two. Furthermore, my lord, on the first appearance of this matter, I've said this before, Ms. M. Giacco is on record in Boksburg Magistrate Court. He further went on record in Phukeng, where accused two was recorded. So I don't understand, my lord, why would such a person appear in all these matters more than once, yet there are no instructions from accused two?
Uthi ubrigadiri akazwisisi ukuthi usho njani ntanzi mawuthi wena awuzange uthi umji yakho akumele, awuzange uthi umji yakho ummeli wakho, awuzange futhi uxhumane nokuthi umji yakho nangu uye wena makafika ubrigadiri umtshele ukuthi umji yakho ummeli wakho. Uthi lokho akakuzwisisi into yokuqala, futhi ngeyi-24 wena uthi uye washawa waphoqwa ukuthi usayine ngale eGermiston, wena usayine incwadi eyikuthi yayikade ichithelekwe igazi. Uyakuphika lokho uthi le anayo yena ayinalo igazi kodwa inayo isignature yakho, futhi yena uyasho ukuthi njengoba wena uthi awusayinanga i-confession kumantshi, uthi naleyo akulona iqiniso ngoba umantshi ubhalile futhi nokuthi umji yakho wayekade ekhona, nayo leyo confession ekumantshi uyisayinile. Uyamangala futhi nokuthi kuza kanjani ukuthi wena uma uthi umji yakho kwakungasiwummeli wakho, kuza kanjani uma uqala ukuvela la kuleli cala umji yakho wayekhona, kuza kanjani ephutyeni umji yakho wayekade ekhona?
My lord, I also wanted to add that that confession in my recollection by the magistrate was concluded, I think, around 1700 hours, but definitely before 1600 hours. So it was concluded that that is the end time.
On which date, sir?
On the 24th of June, 2020, my lord.
24th June, okay.
Yes. So there was no activities of a confession by the magistrate or that was concluded in the evening. That is not true. I mean, and the document is available, which we disclose to the defense. But I want to go back, my lord, to something that I've said earlier, that really I don't see a reason why a presiding officer, why the magistrate who took this confession will participate in these illegal activities of giving a confession, because it's a crime. To police officers to go and assault somebody when she documented something and put a signature, I can't find a reason. It's shocking for me, my lord, to say, even to try and comprehend that you can involve yourself in such, my lord. It simply doesn't make sense, my lord. And I must be honest, I don't really believe it, my lord. I don't think it's true.
Uthi akakholwa ukuthi umantshi uye wathatha incwadi le ekuthi wayekade eyibhalile ngalesikhathi nizeme nikhuluma, wayinika amaphoyisa ukuthi amaphoyisa bayokushaya bese bayakusayinisa. Uthi cha, akazi isizathu ukuthi kungahle kube yini umantshi angayenza into enjalo, umuntu osebenza ngomthetho. Uthi akayikholwa leyo ukuthi kungaba yiqiniso, ngoba leya confession iyenzwe emini